Mike Malahan, vice president of AIM Consulting, an IT company with a local office anchored in Bellevue. I don't have to tell anyone listening to this show that our world has changed dramatically over the last several months. There are many people projecting what the future will look like when we begin to return to some normalcy. I thought Mike, being in the business that he is in, might have some good suggestions for us to consider. Like, for example, is this a good time to start a business? What should companies do to make it through these challenging times? I first asked Mike to give us an overview of AIM Consulting before we get into the other questions.
AIM is an information technology consultancy, and we're based out of Bellevue, Washington, with offices in Houston, Chicago, Minneapolis, and Denver. And our offerings are based around application development, data and analytics, cloud and infrastructure, digital experience, and delivery leadership. We're about a 400-person company, and we have a pretty diverse customer base from everything from retail, oil and gas, biogenetics, life sciences, automotive, and everything in between.
All over the board. How long has the company been around?
Company's been around, I think we're close to 13 years now.
Okay. And what does a vice president of consulting do?
My job, and I mentioned those core offerings or areas, those practice areas roll up to me in the Seattle office. So along with organizing the resources to execute underneath those practices, I'm also focusing the team on what technology stacks and what verticals and what resource areas we need to focus on as we develop our company and adapt to not just changes in our economy and everything else that's going on right now, but technology in general, which is changing at a pretty rapid rate.
Yeah, and sometimes when I look at a company like yours, an IT company, you're positioned pretty well right now, I would think.
We are, and to be honest, we weren't sure how we would be positioned with everything that's going on, but it's pretty remarkable that technology can ease a lot of the constraints that happen with the isolation that people have. Providing access through a technology medium to products and services is certainly one way to help companies reach their customers. And we're definitely well aligned to help resolve those issues with our customers.
Is it too early, or are you having discussions now of what your company will look like and a lot of your customers will look like, let's say, in the next 6 months or so? Is it still kind of like, well, let's just see how this thing unfolds and not make any dramatic decisions now?
That's certainly the key question. And we meet on a weekly basis, our leadership team, and we talk about, you know, what is going on right now that is affecting our customers and how the climate is changing and what we need to address. And frankly, the changes are still happening pretty rapidly. And so you think of things like the rental car industry and travel. It's very fluid how they're reacting and what their plans are for the future. And so we're still along for the ride. You know, we're certainly there to help them execute their plans, but I think there's still a lot of uncertainty in the next 6 to 9 months to really know how things are going to play out.
What would you suggest a company do now in terms of looking forward, not getting too far ahead of themselves and staying grounded? Do you have any kind of ideas that you'd suggest that they really take a strong look at?
I do. One is adapt, of course, and I see, thankfully, that we're integrated with a lot of large enterprise customers as well as some mid-sized companies. And we've been able to see a multitude of different plans executed in the last 2 to 3 months. And my recommendation, and the ones that are successful right now, are the ones that are acting quickly. There's a lot of methodologies in product development, application development, and leadership around failing fast and executing quickly. These companies that are trying things in a rapid pace and focusing on providing customer service and getting their products to market to the best of their abilities are still having a lot of success. And so definitely adapting is a recommendation. Another one I have is more focused on maybe a little bit looking in the rearview mirror, but this is a disaster recovery scenario for a lot of companies, and it may be one that's not in a playbook for a lot of companies. So my recommendation is we all need to learn some lessons from this particular scenario and knowing that there could be a very large disruption in your ability to reach your customers and deliver your products. And you need to have a plan for that. And so as we work our way out of this situation, my recommendation to companies is to start building that plan if you haven't already. And think of things like having your employees work remotely and how that impacts your ability to lead and manage them. These are all things that are a part of a successful business delivery plan.
Do you think that a lot of people will be working remotely going forward, or is that being exaggerated? You know, you hear downtown Seattle and even downtown Bellevue, all this real estate that's been built, and all of a sudden these buildings are going to be empty.
I'm sure the answer is somewhere in between, and the results are still somewhat out on that. But I can tell you from our perspective, having 400 employees working remote has been surprisingly, it has gone quite well. Resources have adapted. It's not been easy, as we've all probably had to find ways to set up offices in our homes and internet connectivity. And there's always challenges using meeting technologies online. But I think in the heavy technology spaces where resources can work in a remote environment, I think a lot of companies will be much more willing in the next couple of years to allow that to happen. And I think the productivity will be, it will be on par as the way it's been in the past. So frankly, there's just a social side of human interaction that people do enjoy. We've seen an interesting dynamic with a lot of our employees that the isolation isn't pleasant for a lot of people, and they do want to have those interactions still. So there's a lot to be addressed and unpackaged in that question, but I do think there will be some willingness to allow more and more employees to work from home.
Yeah, and it doesn't have to be absolutely one way or the other. There can be some in between here. I mean, maybe some employees come in Monday, Wednesday, Friday from, you know, let's say 9 o'clock to 3 o'clock or things like that.
Yeah, I agree. It is going to be some kind of a mixed plan like that. And I think for those people that just work better from an office environment, assuming it's safe to do so, I think those opportunities will still always be there, maybe in just a smaller capacity.
Do you think this is a good time to start a business? And if so, what kind of companies do you think will maybe thrive more than others?
Yeah, I do think it is a good time for the right mindset. I think people that are entrepreneurs in nature, that are forward-looking and adapt well to a changing environment, I think this is a great time because, for one, there's a lot of resources available to them. People are away from the distractions of an office. Their calendars are very well established with time available for mentoring and discussions about opportunities to help each other. And I think this is a great time to access that knowledge and experience. And you can start building, you know, a customer base now. You can start building excitement around your products, and you can do it in a way that hasn't been done previously. You know, pure digital marketing and reaching resources in a new medium. It's actually quite exciting if you have the right mindset. Technology right now is, you know, a way of solving a lot of problems from every aspect of our lives. And the companies that are faced with some of these challenges, they've got a lot to think about and a lot to develop in the next coming months and years to address something that came on so quickly. There's a lot of opportunity in there. And I'm sure there will be a lot of companies that aren't successful and aren't able to continue because of these things. It's certainly going to be an interesting time, but I think as human beings, we all want to march on. And I'm fairly interested to see what happens next, because I think there's going to be a lot of innovation in the next coming year or 2 years that's going to potentially change all of our lives.
Just before we go, I wanted to make an observation, and that is, like, Amazon, of course, has taken over the world in many ways. Amazon has changed retail dramatically. Don't even need to go into any more detail than that on it. And my feeling is that this is the direction we were headed anyhow. This just shortened that timetable.
You're absolutely right. Amazon is a great example, and there's several more out there that are changing the way there's less and less need for physical interactions to consume products. And companies and retailers are always looking for ways to make that interaction simpler, easier, and of course, faster.
That's Mike Malahan, Vice President of AIM Consulting, with an office in Bellevue.